So here we are, Have a Mega, day two. The wind is very light. We have some wind on the outside of the course, as you can see. It's blowing about 5 knots, plus or minus. But it's still very light. The course is out that way somewhere. I'll spin around here and you can get a view of the beach. All the boats waiting on the beach. A group of hecklers heckling the race committee. There's a few more boats down that way. The water's very beautiful today. It's very clear, like it was the other day. It's probably about 10 feet deep down there right now. You can see my shadow on the bow of the boat there. It's a really nice day weather-wise, and we could get some wind. There's a slight wind line out there toward the west, and it could fill, possibly. The boats are moving. There's a bunch of boats out on the course, but yeah, who knows what's going to happen. This Tiger's moving okay. We're still in our assessment mode to see how much effort we want to put into this, because rumor has it that there are two untapped kegs on the beach at the ready, so we'll see what happens. But we're going to start towing some boats out there and see if we can get some races off today. It's still pretty light now. The time is about 1:30. It's very light out here, but AP is down and boats are leaving the beach. We're giving boats tows out to the different courses. Johnny and I today are on Bravo course, and so we're towing the 17s and the 18s out to the race course. Alpha course are the Tigers and the 20s, and all of the Tigers and 20s are getting off the beach right now. There's Dan Ketterman on Bravo course, A-mark boat. He's towing some 17s and 18s out as well. And yeah, people are excited about this. See what happens today. It's still very, very light on the inside here, and there are some light patches out there, but definitely we're hitting the water, and we're gonna do some towing. It's gonna be all good, hopefully. You can see it's kind of getting light. There's a little breeze here on the beach, then it goes to a light spot, and you can see a wind line on the outside there toward California, toward the west. And so we're towing people out there, and we'll see what happens. Don't want to pull it clean and get arrested. There's a sheriff right there. Well, actually, Johnny, could you give us a little spin us around? Interacting with them is not on my list of things to do today. And everything's looking pretty nice. That's what we do. That's how we roll. All right, we're gonna blast up to Alpha course. Oh, by the way, on this race course, they're making us use bricks to anchor. They don't like anchors in the lake, so we're using bricks, which totally jack up my whole freaking fore deck. There's a big hole in it, but whatever, that's cool. Should put some carpet down or something. Basically told Matt that he's missing a couple of crews.
Yeah, later.
Pin boat's done. Pin boat's gone. We're too hot. We're over it. 15 seconds to start. First start on Bravo course for the Have a Mega. It's howling. Matt bounds. There's a start. Everybody's over early, Matt Bounds says. I didn't even see one person cross a line of any kind. You can see the wind meter that Johnny's holding. It's not even spinning one bit.
We turn around.
Reading the snake eyes. Oh, it almost spun. Oh, looks like we have a little traffic jam at the start line there. Yeah. Major traffic here at the starting line in this first race on Bravo course here at the Have a Mega. Here comes this 18 right behind us. We're on the pin boat here. You can see the flag there. Bounds is down there behind that giant cluster there, right, that are stopped right. All of those boats are stopped dead on the line. Matt Bounds is down there about 500 feet south of us there. And here comes an 18. He's got a nice clean start. Look at him go. Look at him.